They charged Jesus with sedition. Didn't they do that? They said he was against Caesar. They said he was discriminating because he told his disciples, go not the way of the Gentiles, but rather go to the lost sheep. He discriminated. Don't go near the Gentiles, go to the lost sheep. Go to the oppressed. Go to the downtrodden. Go to the exploited. Go to the people who don't know who they are, who are lost from the knowledge of themselves, and who are strangers in a land that is not theirs. Go to those people. Go to the slaves. Go to the second-class citizens. Go to the ones who are suffering the brunt of Caesar's brutality. And if Jesus were here in America today, he wouldn't be going to the white man. The white man is the oppressor. He would be going to the oppressed. He would be going to the humble. He would be going to the lowly. He would be going to the rejected and the despised. He would be going to the so-called American Negro.
According to the Federal Office of Minority Health, African Americans are affected by serious diseases and health conditions at a far greater rate than other Americans. In fact, African Americans suffer an estimated 85,000 excess deaths every single year from diseases that we know how to prevent. We're talking about heart disease, stroke, cancer, high blood pressure, and diabetes.
It's true that being black in America is hazardous to your health. African Americans have higher rates of diseases like HIV/AIDS, hypertension, and diabetes, and are more likely to die from violence and have less access to quality health care.
Several years ago, two physicians in Chicago set out to solve a mystery. Why do African-American women have babies that are born too small at twice the rate of white American women? Richard David and James Collins are neonatologists, pediatricians who specialize in the care of infants who come into the world too early or dangerously underweight, and often both. Like virtually everyone in their field, they were troubled by the striking racial differences in rates of premature and low birth weight babies. What could account for the differences?
I originally thought that the disparity in premature delivery was really driven by socioeconomic differences between African Americans and whites. It is well known that African Americans have a lower collectively socioeconomic status than whites, are less likely to receive college education than whites. So I thought once you correct it for that, that the gap would go away.
But Collins and David discovered the gap didn't go away.
We were very surprised to find that the gap actually widened as education and socioeconomic status improved.
There's something about growing up as a black female in the United States that's not good for your childbearing health. I don't know how else to summarize it.
Doctors, at a loss for a scientific explanation, now believe the everyday stress of being a black woman in a mostly white society is the cause.